whatsoever anymore. This is not a projection. This is now. We need to wake up fast. And more importantly, we need to grow up fast, okay? We need some courage here. We need people to open their eyes, open their minds, and not concede and freeze to fear. It can be frightening what we're talking about here, but I tell you, it's more frightening when the knock comes on the door than if we start to get involved now. And we can start to make it much more difficult for that knock on the door to happen. Come on. Your want to do? Well, you do if you want to live in anything like a free world. And I'll say this to people who are focused on the positive. Tell your children and grandchildren that you focused on the positive. When they realize that they are going to have to live in a world, and by then we'll be living in a world, unless if we don't put the brakes on fast, which makes today look like a free and open society. Because we've not reached the point of it yet. They want a global Orwellian state that would make Orwell wince. And tell your children and grandchildren who are going to have to live in that when you've gone, that you focused on the positive. Grow up. What is spiritual about looking the other way while this is going on? Being spiritual is to go above fear. And I love that when people say, "Oh, you mustn't focus on the fear. It's frightening." Well, hold on a second. I thought you said you were spiritual and you let go of fear. Well, if you've let go of fear, there's nothing to be frightened of, is there? We are consciousness. We are infinite consciousness. We are all that is, has been, and ever will be. What we're having at this time is a experience in a computer program called Planet Earth and humanity, right? That's what we're having. Now, whatever happens in the experience, we are still infinite consciousness, all that has been, is, and ever will be. But the question is, do you want to have an experience that's as deeply unpleasant as this one is going to be? Do you want your children and grandchildren to have that experience? Right? Because that's the question. And if you really are conscious, if you really are in touch with your, quote, higher self, then looking at the other way and conceding your right to act as necessary to fear is not going to happen, is it? The only time it's going to happen that you're going to be consumed by fear or look the other way and convince yourself that there's nothing you should do because it's all negative, the only time that you're going to be in that mode is if you are not conscious. If you are not in touch with your, quote, higher self, but if you are consumed by the body-mind, which sees everything in terms of denial, everything in terms of fear. Do you think infinite consciousness is going to look at the situation we're facing and say, it's negative, you must focus on the problem? No! It's going to say, I'm going to do what I know to be right. And what we know to be right in the face of a tyranny is to not concede ourselves to the tyranny. Peaceful, non-violent, non-cooperation, because this tyranny can only be imposed upon us if we concede ourselves to allow it. The people in full knowledge of what's going on and what they're doing, compared to the global population, is a handful. The global population, we are told, is about 7 billion people. And the 7 billion are the people who are subjected to this horror by the handful of people who in full knowledge are doing it. It can only happen with our acquiescence. There is not enough of them to do it without our acquiescence. And they have to get us to don uniforms and don dark suits to act as agents for the few, to impose the will of the few upon the many. And those people in uniform and dark suits who are doing this, you look your children and grandchildren in the eye as well, and you tell them that you can justify what you're doing in relation to the world they're going to have to live in. You're helping to bring it in. What are you doing? We need to stop being in denial and start looking this in the eye. And then the billions can sort out the few who are seeking to impose a horror movie upon the rest of us. We can do it, but only if we come together and get out of denial and stop the excuses of it's negative, must focus on the positive. You know what's positive? What's positive thing to focus on? This tyranny not completing what it wants to complete. Tell me something more positive than that at this time.